Hello everybody, it's Eva from the Zabby Tiger here again. I would like to say huge thanks to all of you for watching my videos, for leaving amazing comments. I would like to say thank you so much to new subscribers and to old as well, of course. And I do appreciate every single comment you are leaving under my videos on YouTube or on Facebook pages. I just don't have a time to answer because when I have to write down in English, it's taken time for me. So I'm so sorry. I'm getting this very slowly. I know. I'm so sorry for that. I hope you understand. Today, I would like to continue in some kind of things sharing about making journals. In last video, we made about those making journals, we made few covers. I showed you few ideas. So today I would like to show you for more more ideas what you can do with book pages. So this is all cover we made that last time. Oh my god, it will be very interesting again. And you know, it's so many different books, of course, and so many different papers they are using in those books. So I will try to show you or tell you my experiences with all those papers. You know, we are using book pages like or all pages in all journals, and they are amazing, and they are brilliant embellishment, a brilliant expand of all pages. I don't know how to explain it. And we are using them for envelopes. We cover them with so many different pictures, napkins. I have to say, Marina Wilson on YouTube, she has amazing tutorial how you can decorate your book pages with napkins, and also she made their very easy envelopes out of book pages. So I will put link for this video down below, and also because Christmas are coming. And it's totally amazing project our out of book, and I saw that project 2 years ago, and I know I will do it again this year, and I already started, but I chose the wrong book. I already started to do another Christmas tree. I saw a video, I think 2 years ago, on this channel. She is Betsy Doodle here on YouTube, and that tutorial was brilliant, and I did my Christmas trees, and this time I chose the wrong book. So I have to go on Sunday market and find another book. But I will definitely do again Christmas tree. So I will try to find that video as well, and I'm going to share with you a few tips what you can do from those papers. In most of dictionaries, those all the dictionaries books, it's using very light paper. You know that not heavy grammage. They are very light. They are brilliant. This is more heavy. I think it's higher grammage, and this book paper, it's nearly like cardstock. It's very very heavy grammage, very high grammage. And this paper from dictionaries or from some old books. I've got here, this is from book with stamps, and it's same, probably same grammage. It's very light papers. So those papers are brilliant for embellishments. I will try to move this stuff somewhere, and I will show you later, probably few of them. This paper, it's brilliant for making your own washi tape. I already prepared this one. As you can see, I placed my double-sided tape from one side, and from that other side, I'm gonna show you what I'm doing. I know my tapes are finished somewhere here, and here is so many pictures already. I'll try to place it a little bit down, maybe you will see better than what I'm doing. Oops, sorry for that moving. And because this has already so many pictures, I don't need to use so many another pictures. I will show you from this dictionary, book pages. I already made my own washi tapes. I use those small stamps from Tim Holtz. I'm not sure why my camera is not zooming, but I hope you see that. I use those hands, crowns, tickets, clocks. Ah, it's zooming right now. And I think it's beautiful washi tape, and when I will use it, I will just distress those edges, and I think it's beautiful washi tape. So I'm gonna show you what you can do if you've got already some pictures. I think some writing, it's brilliant to use it. Something like this, it's Tim Holtz stamp with those numbers. It's brilliant to use. And that basic on this page, it's black ink. So I'm guessing in this case will be good to use some brown ink, and we will see that result. I'm gonna use this. I can't say that. I'm so sorry. We will be here one more hour if I will have to say that. That name of that ink, but it's Ranger. Ranger brand, I think. Yes, it's Ranger. Adirondack. Oh my god, it's espresso. Espresso color. Oh my. I'm gonna stamp it. It's a little bit dark. Wet it. Where is my napkin? Here is my napkin. Come on. It was too much. Stamp it again. If you've got too much ink and you don't like it, just try to stamp your stamp on some another paper alongside. Yes, I think this result is better than that very heavy inked. Here you can see still all those images. Stamp it like this. Bottom. Some numbers. This is too heavy. Stamped. And I think now I can use, I'm gonna use this hand, hopefully you see that it's so dirty, I'm so sorry. I'm gonna use that hand, this hand. Oh gosh. Stamp it here and there. And there you can use some flowers and make a romantic washi tape. It's so many different ways how you can decorate your own washi tape. And now I'm gonna move it a little bit up again, make me here space. Now just take your double-sided tape and rip that paper, and you've got your own washi tape with your own stamps and with that book page under. It's a little bit crazy, but I think it's beautiful. And if you've got some scraps, some pieces, here is too heavy. Yeah, do not use so heavy ink. I will repeat later. So what else I can show you? You know, we using our book pages like envelopes as well. And I saw on that Marina Wilson channel how she made her envelopes. I hope I got somewhere here. I think I got. Yes. She made this type of envelopes that you folding a book page twice. One is a little bit shorter. It's for that lid, that clop. My God, I hope you will understand. One shorter scoring line. It's for that clop, and those. The rest score in middle and fold it, and it will be your envelope. And it's very easy. She's glued it together on this side, inside, on this side and this side. And I think she's got there also sewn envelopes. But I don't have sewing machine, I think in hand I will just ruin that paper. So I use this foil decorative tape, and I tape it over. So I didn't use any glue here and any glue there, but this tape is holding my pages, and I think it looks really brilliant. Maybe I should use the tape on the bottom as well. It will be more decorative, and here I've got a huge space where I can place some picture, like here. And this I made a little bit different way. As you can see, you can make your own envelope without using any machine, any scoring board, but without any that envelope puncher or something like this. You can do it on your own, so beginners or people like I am, who don't have so many equipment, that special machines and something like that, we can do it itself. And it's pretty easy. I'm gonna show you. You just need to make your own heart and score it on those sides. Score it. So if you've got a scoring line, place those 2 points. I'm gonna show you where is mine. Oops. Yeah. Do not laugh, okay? This is my scoring board. Also my trim. So, place this middle lane on some scoring, this scoring lane, to make sure that it's in one line. And then count how far from that middle lane. Yeah, I said it right. From that middle lane, how far you will score this side at the same size score here. Then fold it. And I scored this at first, and then I fold that end. I fold it to that scoring line, but you can score all those lines to count it somehow. I think it's much more easy that you will first score this one, then you will probably count how far it's from here to here and score it in middle. That way it will be probably very easy if you need to make scoring lines. I did score only this one, and then this I fold with my hands, and it make beautiful envelope. And I think it's very easy. Just draw your own heart. Try to keep this cutting. Just draw half of your heart and then cut it out. It's very easy. And try to keep this same same direction like this. Because then you can be sure that you will cover this open space with your flop with this. So this is envelope, and that other one I will place link for Marina's channel, for Marina's video down below. What else I can show you? Another pocket. I can show you very easy pocket. Just bear with me. I'm gonna take some. Here I've got book page, and this is very light. It's much more better for those washi tapes, or maybe for those crackle flowers. Oh, I made one flower. I have to show you. Where is my flower? I lost my flower. Oh my god, I lost it. No, I didn't. I made one flower. I'm not making flowers, but I tried. It's horrible. I use dyes from this Marianne design, those dyes, and I made my own flower from book pages. Just made layouts, but it's very easy. I watched videos from Leonie. She's passion for paper, I think. my passion for paper, what I wanted to do. Oh, another pocket. I know. Gosh. So I will make a huge pocket probably here. Just fold once and then fold that other end and make sure they are covering each other in some point where you will glue it together. So fold that other end as well. You can score all those lines if you want to have some measurement. Now I will use my scoring tool, because here I will make scoring line. I will find my scoring tool. Do not laugh, okay? I will make gap probably 1 inch, because I wanna have this end. It will be like bottom of my pocket. So I wanna use it like bottom of my pocket, and also I wanna use it like end, which I will use for glue it to my journal page. I will show you what I mean. And this is basic for my pocket. It will be here. One of those will be glued inside, like bottom of my pocket, and that third will be used for glued that pocket to my journal envelope. And if you wanna have this end with some beautiful edge, I have to show you what I learned. If you don't have this Sizzix machine or any cutting machine, you don't have to be afraid, you can do it yourself. Just use your scissors. If maybe you've got some, maybe I can do it. If you've got some scissors, some decorative scissors like those are, just cut those corners in some decorative style. But if you've got a cutting machine, I'm going to show you what I learned. I'm pretty happy. I know many of you knows that already many years and you are using it, but I know it only a few weeks. I learned that. I accidentally found it. I wanted to found it many weeks ago when I saw that. When you want to have your edge ended with some decorative end on your pocket, and you wanna use dies for it, remember to make sure that your dies will don't cut all that shape, they will cut only that edge, to make sure that you will place it right way on your plates, on those plates. First, try to place your dies on your pocket how you think you want to cut that pocket. I think I want to cut it somehow like this. Hopefully I'm not too bad. And I want to finish that cutting in this position and this position. Somewhere there. Like this, I think I'm guessing like this. So I have to place that metal dies will finish in that position where I want to end that cutting. I hope my explanation will be understandable. I know, I'm horrible. I want to have end of cutting here. So here is ending my plate. So here will be... I will place, oh my god, it's hard to explain for me, but I hope you see what I'm doing. I'm so sorry for my explanation, I don't know how to explain it. I don't want to have cut all that rest, so I can't have this plate under. It have to be free space, it have to be air under my paper, where I don't want to have cutting that die. So I'm gonna fix it And as I don't have that repositionable tape, I'm using those note pads. I'm gonna fix it. Come on. And I just cleaned that a few weeks ago. Yeah, quite happy with this. Go through to your machine. And we will see if I did it right. I'm gonna take this. I'm gonna take this. And we will see. Did it? Yeah, nearly, nearly. It wasn't cut those edges. But as you can see, it was... Yeah, probably I should place it a little bit up. But it was cut that top. And it wasn't cut that end where was air under. It wasn't that plate. Hopefully you understand what I mean. I'm so sorry for my explanation. It's horrible. I'm gonna use my scissors for those edges. And we're gonna continue with making this small... Oh, not small. This large pocket, or what is it? So it's like this one. And I still didn't glue it together, okay? Oops. I'm gonna move my machine. Now, I know I've got that scoring line here. Incline. I'm gonna place there double-sided tape for all that line. It's okay. Oops. Okay, I've got my double-sided tape here. Now, a little bit small triangle in those scoring lines, because here is scoring line, okay? So here, small, I can, yeah, here is one scoring line, so I cut it with small shape, and here is another scoring line, so I will cut it like this, so it makes small triangles. It's better when you glue in papers together, it's not making here that huge bound or papers and those tapes. So it's better if you're making this shape. And now we have to decide how we will glue it together. So I know this will be like last layer of those layers, so I can place double-sided tape on this one as well. I'm gonna place my double-sided tape on this, oops, as well. And now this will be on the top, and I want to have this bent down. It will be like my decoration. So I will bend it down, fold it down, and now I will take my... I will take my distress ink. I will distress those edges. This one here, and this will be fold like this. So those two will be etched from inside this and this. That will be, those edges will be distressed from inside. It will be like this, and we will have all those edges. Now this one, I hope it's not too much complicated what I'm showing you. And now we are going to glue it together, okay? So I know This part will be inside this side of my pocket, and this will be lie on it. So this I'm going to glue inside at first. It will be using this side. Just put it in and place your page down and glue it. Now take off this side. And same it will be with this. You don't have to use this flip. You can cut it out and it will glued to this one. And if you will put glue on this end, or whenever it's ending on that end of this side, it will be glued down all together. But I'm using it, so just place it inside. And sometimes it's too complicated, I know, but like this, I'm sure that from here will be anything falling down. And place this on the top, so you've got your pocket. Here you can glue down and you can distress all those edges. And we also have this end, which we can glue down to our page in a journal or in a photo album in our projects. Oh my god, I hope you understood just a little bit, maybe. I'm so sorry for that explanation. What else I can show you? Oh my god, it's not too many times. I can show you butterfly, beautiful butterfly using dye, book page dye. I already die cut this one from book page. I hope you can see that it's from book page. And I already made butterfly using this one. And it looks brilliant. As you can see that the book page is showing there. And I've got one book page under that. This is sticker, so I'm gonna stick it on book page on some paper. I'm gonna stick it down. Then I'm going to take my scissors, I'm gonna cut it around, and then I will glue down this die and place some gem here, and it will make beautiful, beautiful embellishment. I don't have so many time on my counting, so I'm gonna show you a little bit more. You can make rosettes from your book pages and put there some, this was button, and I believe that on some pocket it will be beautiful embellishment. Also you can make tiles using book page. I used my Christmas stamps, I stamped them on book page, then I used double-sided tape, I glue it on chipboard, and now I will make just that top coat, that glossy varnish, probably top coat. Another way how you can use especially in a romantic on in that shabby chic style, you can make shape of hearts out of book pages, out of this is napkin, this is that white paper under your napkin. I'm always saving them, so you can use that napkin, you can cut out that heart and make few layers, then stick it together. You can use glue or just that machine, this one. This one. Stick it together with this. I don't remember name of that. Oh, my minutes are nearly on end. And used some embellishment on it. And I believe it will be beautiful, beautiful embellishment for your project. And I wanted to make paperback. So I will see if I will put together again two videos. For now, I'm saying thank you so much for watching. Thank you to all of you for subscribing to my channel. I hope you always will find some inspiration. Hopefully, I will put two videos together. If not, it will be another video, very short video with book pages and how to use them. Thank you for now, and see you next time. Bye. Okay, I'm back. And I'm just going to show you, this was that kind of small pocket we made. I hope you understood just a little bit how I made it. And here is just, I want to show you how it can look like. This is in that winter style, so you can decorate it with button and with snowflake, which is already cut out of book page as well. And I just used glue and that glittered sand on it. And I think it will look brilliant on some Christmas journal. And here, I want to show you, this is how you can use decoupage paper, napkins and decoupage your book pages. This is about cars, so I'm gonna use it in my winter journal. And here is small same pocket, and here I can show you how I meant it to glue it to your page. It's not finished yet, it's just, so you will glue it down and you can cover it with some lace or another paper or with some winter sign, that Christmas wishing or something like this. And from here it has pocket, so you can place there tags. They are brilliant, make out of books, book pages. This is that other side of that book page. I'm gonna show you how I made it all. I just made layouts like this. It will be brilliant to have it like this. I know. And I used again magnets, so you can use your book pages like your basic of your pages in your journal. And you can decorate them with lace, and they look brilliant, they look lovely. So you can do it this way. Now about tags. You know that we are using tags many times, 100 times in our projects. So you can make just normal kind of vintage style of tag, nothing, just from one side book page, from other side some plain paper or linen paper, and it will be brilliant tag in your project. Or you can decorate it somehow. Here I used small metal tag, and I still forgot to put there something. I will put there some charm. And from other side it's happy holidays. As you can see, there is my washi tape I made before, and I think it will be brilliant embellishment for some Christmas journal. Oh my god, I'm mumbling again. Here another way how you can decorate your tags. It's very easy way. I think I will still play with this and decorate it a little bit more, probably, I'm not sure yet. Or you can just stamp your book page, and as you can see here, I made layouts with my stamps. And maybe I can show you how you can make layouts with your stamps. Maybe I still got here, I can explain you. I know, I will show you. Will I? Because I have to find those stamps.
I will find them. Oopsie, just nearly fell down. Okay,
I'm gonna do it different way. I've got here those stamps, so hopefully very quickly I will show you how you can make those decorations, how you can make layouts with your stamps on your book page, and still have seen all this and don't put your other stamp to that previous. So like basic, I wanna have this beautiful face of that Santa, and as I don't have that large, this piece, and this is too, yeah, it's too small. I'm gonna try, wish me luck. I'm gonna place it on my table. I'm gonna use black Stazen ink. Ink it. Is that, you know, it's good to have under my table this one, because then I can use it like my positional. I know it's a little bit tricky. Okay, I'm gonna ink it. Oops. This side. And then I'm gonna use my tag, and I'm gonna place my tag over, and I'm going to use that lid and press it down. Hopefully, nearly. We are nearly there. I forgot to press that button, but I think it's not too bad. To make sure that next stamp. Some piece of. Oh my god! I got loads of book pages here. Believe me, loads of book pages. It's just probably impossible to choose one for me. Horrible. Just stamp your image on some paper. It don't have to be book page, okay? It can be any paper. Stamp your image on paper. Then take your scissors. I will have to take smaller. And cut out that image how it is. Try to cut it out as close to that stamped image as you can. I'm not taking all those curves, which is probably bad, because as perfect you will cut it out, you will have that other stamp in all curves you can have. I'm horrible. And I'm not sure if I said so, that books are amazing for any type of crafts, you know. They are brilliant in home decoration, in home decor. I love that vintage style where in homes are using those from books, making those folds art pieces. I hope I said that I start to work on my Christmas tree again. I'm not sure. Oh my god, I forgot if I said so. And you can make beautiful photo holders out of books as well. And I'm working on a gift box, and not gift box, memory box for my friend, for my lovely friend. She asked me to make memory box for her son. I will remember that. I will continue. Now you need to place this image over like this. You're gonna take where I've... Oh, I've got my stamps here. Oh my god, Evie. I'm gonna take this image and I will stamp it. Yeah, I can stamp it like this. Okay, I'm gonna take green. Do I have green? I have green color here. It's kind of green color. It's going to be tricky because I don't have that. You will see. And you need to place this cutting piece exactly like it's your stamped image. And then stamped that rest. Oops. If you've got that repositional tape, just use it to make sure that your template of your image will be not moving anywhere. And if we will move it, see that stamp, that template was save your image under, and you've got beautiful stamp around. It's a beautiful way how you can use your stamps. So you can make some tags using your books and stamp them like this, or don't stamp them at all. What else? Oh, I told you about, just a minute, I'm gonna cover my inks. I was talking about that gift for my friend, not gift for her. She asked me to make a future gift for her son. It was tricky, tricky asking, tricky request, because she's kind of like I am. I like all those babies albums. I really like it. I always enjoy to watch all those babies albums, but I'm not too much in it. And as I've got my sons already grown to nearly men, I know they will know ever to watch some babies album. So my friend asked me to make for her something where she can save her son pictures, drawing he made, his photos and everything, to give him all this bunch in the future when he will be 18 maybe. So I'm going to make for her journal for writing down some stories, and it will be in a huge box. And I was thinking to use book like photo holder. So just imagine box is, here is box, and this is backside of that box, and there is bottom, and this will be glued down like this. It will be sprayed in black color. I will do it in my steampunk style, because I think in 18 years old boy will rather look to that steampunk than to that baby style. I'm so sorry for that, but I really think so. So I'm gonna do it in steampunk style, and it will be like this. Here will be that backside of my box, and here will be bottom, and it will be open from here, so she can place his photos in this holder. So books can be used in many different styles, and it's brilliant. Here is one, and I'm thinking this paper bag. To be honest, I pinched that from hospital. I'm horrible. But I never had this size of bag. So I pinched this one. And I'm going to alter it. I've got here my duck, which I prepared before. And as you can see, it's brilliant size, so I have to use it. Okay, we're gonna alter our paper bag, and we're gonna use some book page like decoration. Of course, I'm gonna use some laces, and I've got here this from my lovely neighbor. She used that on some dresses, and it's still sewn together, and it was left over what she didn't use. Yes, I'm gonna use this one because it's gorgeous. Look at that, it's beautiful. Okay, I'm gonna use my glue. First, I'm gonna cut it down probably in the size I need. Okay, show me where you are. Here. Come on. Good. Okay, it will be here. Oops, oops, oops. Okay, we will have this decoration here, and I'm thinking I'm gonna use my distress ink, but that I'm gonna use again that juicy, this one, as I want to have that a little bit more strong colors, rich colors. So I'm gonna use this ink pad. Hopefully this is that dry one, so yeah, it's not too bad. I'm gonna distress a little bit those edges. Okay. If I will place this here, and I will place this one here, I think I can do it. Okay, I'm gonna distress those edges as well. A little bit. Oh, I need to be a little bit faster. I'm going to make mom's taxi. My older son have to go again to work, and he just finished all week of 12 hours shifts. So I think he's so tired, so I'm gonna give him a lift to work. Because to catch up bus, it will take ages. And I lost again. Oh my god. Is this possible? I'm always losing everything here.
It's like, oh, I just placed it under.
No, I mean, I didn't lost it, I just... Those, I'm always losing those. If you don't wanna use those metal eyes, eyes something, you can use those paper circles. And as I'm gonna use only that book page, which is not strong enough to keep, to hold that metal piece, I'm gonna use this one. And I want to have it in some kind of shabby chic. Okay, it will be here. I've got here this beautiful picture. And we're gonna use our beautiful picture as well. Okay. To make it older, distress a little bit edges of the picture. Got here vintage photo. It will be again so long time. Oh my god. I'm so sorry for that. I'm very, very slow crafter, I know. I am very slow crafter. It will be here, but I need some embellishments. Okay, I will try to pause this video. Just bear with me. The opposite, it will shake in a little bit. I will try to pause it and I will try to find some dyes probably. Just bear with me. Okay, I'm back. I found this dye. I found those beautiful flowers. It was a wedding banner I purchased a while ago, and I already used that in one romantic journal. So I've got few leftovers. And I found this one, that gold trim, or what is it? And I've got this beautiful necklace from my friends. And I tried to match, found something, and I think it's matching those colors. Here is a little bit green and this is a little bit green as well, so we will try to put it together somehow. I try to place it like this. This will be under somehow like this. Make that beautiful shape. And I was thinking those flowers, let's place them somehow, maybe like this, not to face, of course, not to face, maybe like this, somehow like this, if is it not too, and then this one somewhere I will have to move it somehow. I thought that this will be here with, you can see that, can you? Okay, I'm gonna do something. Pardon me. All right, first of all, we will glue down this one. Ooh, 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 ooh. My lovely glue. Okay. Let's put those roses here. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Then we need to place that this one, but I wanna have that string. This around. I'm not sure why I'm doing this now. few my project was with this wrapping around, and I really like that. Maybe a little bit down. Come here. I think I will place on the back side some double-sided tape to fix that strip around. I've got three scissors here, and I don't know which one to choose. It's again too long. Oh my gosh, I'm horrible. Okay. Now wrap it around somehow. Where is end? Where is the end? Okie dokie. Come on, see there. Good. Yeah. And now, how I will put that this? I need some ribbon. We are in that gold color. Okay, I will put that this ribbon. It will be too much gold. Oh man. Try to put those through that eye. I'm not sure if it will be okay, but we will try it through and place it here. Always we can fix it with hot glue gun, can we? Okay, like this. Here I will probably put a little bit of glue to make sure that it will be not a little bit of glue here under my ribbon, and fix that ribbon over to fix it. Okay, now I've got this, but I don't have that picture. Look at me. I'm guessing that on that place will hot glue gun. The best glue I can use right now. I will place it somewhere here. Come on. Okay, and now we need to place a picture. Show me. Oh yeah, I think she can be here. Like this. Yes, that'll be okay. So many glues, and I think lighting, it's not too good right now. I'm so sorry, I'm too slow. Oh my god, come on Evie, be a little bit faster. Your minutes are again done, nearly done. It's horrible. I'm very slow craft, very slow craft. Here now our picture, and because there is that ribbon which need to be glued down, I'm gonna use again hot glue gun. This, and now those flowers, we will see. Whoa, 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 whoa. Maybe Maybe. Oh, 25 minutes. I'm very slow. I am very slow. That's horrible. Okay. Place it here. One. What else? Scissors. Where are my scissors? Oh, oh mommy. Oh, wow. I'm so sorry. I hope you still can see something. I hope it's not too dark. Hey, mine. It's how I am work. Okay. Oi! No! No, to table. Do not stick to table. Stick there. Move. I don't want to cover hair too much. I think like this should be okay. Oh, fit this. I have to cut out those. Okay, we will put there a little bit of glue. Place it here. And at last, can be here, I think. What do you think? It's like frame around there. Okay. And here is some space for some notes. I don't have any right now, but if I will find something, I will finish that. But this is just very quick project, and it's still paperback, which can be used for some goodies or for something, and I think it's really beautiful. So this is our project we made a few before. I hope you enjoy it, and I hope you like it. I have to place something here, and I will find something, but it's really too many minutes. I've been doing probably nothing. Thank you so much for watching. I'm going to try to put those videos together. Hopefully I will do it fast. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you to all of you for beautiful comments. And in next video I will show you that finished or finished back. Thank you so much, and see you next time. Bye.